Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. So welcome to another episode. Today we have a Monday, the beginning of a new week. Let's see what is going on here on the Bitcoin price, and therefore we're gonna start today with the CME chart. So in the CME chart we have right now a new CME gap since we had this pump during the weekend, and currently we opened up the CMEs also up here at 11,450 here on the CMEs. And as you can see, we have now a new future gap, which usually they tend to close immediately or at least in a very short amount of time. The thing is only that you cannot just trade based on these gaps. So usually they get filled, and I'm also expecting here a potential retest of this area here of around $11,100 to also at the same time close this gap and then maybe have another leg to the upside, since we have broken now from this resistance here of $11,000 and the retest of $12,000 is very likely. So even though there is a very high chance that they will come down here to close this gap pretty soon, maybe today or in the next couple of days, remember that we sometimes have also CME gaps that can stay opened up for a very long time, similar like we had here recently at $9,600. You can see that this gap is still not filled and everyone is waiting for this gap to get filled. And even though we had here this sell-off that came very close here to close the gap, but in theory it is still opened. So if you would have gone here all in with the short position, or you would have sold everything to rebuy back in cheaper here at $9,600, you would have missed all this run-up that we had here from $9,980 up to $12,500. So you cannot just based on the CME gaps go all in with the long or with a short position. So that's why be very careful when you're trading these gaps. Most of the times they get filled very quickly, although this one in my opinion will get filled very quickly, but sometimes we have gaps like this one over here that can stay for a very long time opened till they get eventually filled, because they don't have to get filled, but usually they get filled. And also because Bitcoin is looking so bullish for the long term and we are also post halving, I wouldn't recommend you right now to look for shorts or at least for bearish patterns, because even though it looks like that we here could also fall down here and you could scalp trade here with a little short position, be very careful, because if Bitcoin is going parabolic again, you can get wrecked very, very quickly. So when Bitcoin is breaking significant resistances and also is looking very bullish, especially for the long term, then you should be looking in the short terms for good long entries. So I wouldn't definitely recommend right now to go in with a short to close here this gap and then swap it over into a long position. Maybe it's even better to start longing once this gap is getting closed, and always split your entries so you can manage your trade well, because there is still a high chance that we could even drop towards 9k. This is still in the cards, but if you go with low leverage in or you split your entries, you should be doing fine, even if you start longing here at around $11,000. So when Bitcoin is going parabolic and it is in a bull market, you should look for good long entries. Of course you can do little scalps here when you go short, for example when we see a pattern like this, we have some bearish divergences, we have overbought condition, and also a fresh new CME gap below of us. Of course it is good to open up maybe a little short position, but if the price is going to the opposite direction, so if we're starting here to pump towards 12k and maybe even 14k before we're coming down to close this gap, then make sure to close immediately your trade. So that's why I always use a stop loss. So now that you have seen that we have now here a new CME gap down to $11,100, let's go back to the Bitcoin chart and analyze here the spot market, because after this pump that we have seen this weekend, currently we are in this consolidation here and we are just bouncing up and down from it with the support of 11,320 and currently a resistance of 11,430. So let's see here where we're gonna close an hour or 4 hour candle above or below these important price levels to estimate where we're gonna head to next. If we have a breakout here to the upside, I'm targeting at least 12,500, potentially even higher, but I think 12,000 is still very easy to get reached, especially because we had a very bullish close in the weekly time frame. So here in the lower time frames, like the 1 hour, you can see that here we could have a potential dump here towards the 200 moving average, which currently is also in this price range here of around $11,000, before we could maybe gear up for another big leg to the upside. So there is a very high chance that here we could see a possible fall towards this $11,000. We also had here some bearish divergences in the 1 hour time frame. Some of them already played out, but you can see also that here we are struggling again to push higher, and we are right here at the 50 level in the RSI. So the 1 hour, in my opinion, is starting to look a bit more bearish. So it looks like we could see a possible sell-off towards $11,000, and there in theory have the new support. But therefore, we're gonna have to wait for a possible breakout here, which is coming up in the next couple of hours for sure. And if we have a look here into the Bollinger Band, you can also see that currently we're pushing higher here, so into the bullish area. So if we're gonna have a close now above 11,380, we could in theory push it towards 11,430 again, and then possibly even have a breakout to the upside. But so far, in my opinion, it is more likely that here we are getting rejected and possibly go towards $11,100 in the next couple of hours. We also have MACD and KSD shifted to the downside. Stochastic is in neutral condition. So based on the indicators here, in theory, we could see another leg to the upside incoming here. But if it's going to be sustainable, this is of course what we're going to have to see, and also where these candles are going to close. And if we have a look and a comparison to the DXY, you can see that currently we had a little bounce here to the upside. We tested a 20 moving average in the 1 hour, but it seems like we are getting rejected here. And in that case, we could see a possible continuation here to the downside. And that, of course, will be very bullish for the Bitcoin price. Let's see if here the DXY is able to push higher here towards the 50 or 200 moving average to retest the new resistance and then continue to drop here, or if we're gonna see continuation right now here to the downside. And now let's go back to the Bitcoin chart and open up the 4 hour, because here we got a sell signal, and also currently we are coming very close to the 20 moving average at 11,240. If we are able to bounce from this moving average, if we're gonna see here a breakout to the downside, then this should lead into a big bounce, and in that case we will see most likely continuation to the upside, even if we maybe see a wick towards the $11,100 CME gap. Also bounce from this new support and then continue to trade to the upside. Important is that we don't gonna close a 4 hour candle below 11,240. RSI is also looking a bit toppy here, so here I could imagine to see a possible drop here towards the 20 moving average, maybe even towards the 50, which is here at $10,900, in my opinion, also still very likely to come. And if we have a look here into the Bollinger Band in the 4 hour, you can see that currently we're still trading on the bullish side. So in theory, we could see another leg towards $11,600. But if this is gonna be sustainable, this is what we're gonna have to see if we have another big leg up here to the upside, and also consolidation above $11,500. But as long as we're trading below $11,500, I think there is a very high risk that we will come down here to at least maybe test the middle line here, potentially even drop lower towards $11,000 to also close the CME gap. We also have here KSD and MACD with a bearish cross, so this could lead into a potential sell-off here towards $11,000. The problem here is only that the stochastic is oversold right now, so in theory we could see here another big leg up here, so another big bounce, and that's why also the price could have maybe a final leg to the upside before a potential correction towards 11,000. But as I told you, my friends, it's not guaranteed that we have immediately to go down right now to close the $11,000 CME gap. It would be better if we would have the gap above of us, so we can easily start to long right now, because shorting Bitcoin is always very risky, and usually this leads into liquidations the more you open up shorts. So usually I recommend you only to wait for good long opportunities, but if you open up shorts, then maybe really with just small amounts and low leverage, so you can easily also exit your trade without having too high losses. And now let's compare it to the DXY, because here currently we also have a buy signal, And this also looks like that we could have a possible bounce here towards the 220 moving average at 93.40, maybe to also confirm that this area now is the new resistance and then continue to the downside, because the DXY is in a bear market and it is still looking very bearish here, and I'm expecting big continuation to the downside, even though we have sometimes here some pullbacks to the upside, and of course this will lead into some corrections in the Bitcoin price. And now let's open up the daily time frame in the Bitcoin price, because currently here we are having the 20 daily moving average trading again above the 50, which of course is very bullish. This is what we want to see. And even though we could get rejected up here and could see a possible sell-off towards $11,000, where also the 20 daily moving average is lining up, I think this should be now a very nice support. And even though there could be still the chance that we could drop here towards 200 daily moving average at 9,650, if you think that here in the next couple of days and weeks we will see prices again above $12,000 and $14,000, then I think $11,000 will be a very nice entry for a long position and also to buy some more Bitcoin. Because if you DCA down to the 200 moving average here at 9,650, you should have a very nice long entry, and also you can scale in some nice Bitcoin positions for the next big parabolic run. We have currently here the RSI coming up here towards the overbought condition, but we still have some room left to the upside. So maybe here we could see another correction down to the 50 level and then another bounce to the upside. This is what I'm expecting here in order also to close the CME gap right now. But as I told you, we don't have to go necessarily today down here to close the CME gap. We can also go way, way later down to close the gap and then have a nice bounce from it. So if you don't want to take this risk to go short right now, then just wait here in case that the price is really coming down to start to scale in longs once we're reaching these levels down here at $11,000. Me for myself, maybe I will take a little short position here just to ride it down to the CME gap, and if we're starting to go again above $12,000, I will just exit my trade with a small loss, but that is okay. If you want to take the chance to multiply a little bit your Bitcoin, of course you also have to take this kind of risk. And now let's open up the Bollinger Band in the daily, because here we are still overshooting it to the upside. So correction down maybe here to the first moving average at $11,000 is very likely. Everything is coinciding down to the $11,000, and also it would be healthy to go down to test this new support and have a nice big bounce from it. If we go lower, so if we go to the middle line, then watch out for this $10,800 level. And the bottom is currently here at 10,240. That was also our bearish target in case that we had a breakout to the downside from this consolidation that we were in here in the last couple of weeks. But since now we broke out to the upside, I think it is very likely that we will see continuation to the upside also in the next coming days, even though we will have also some pullbacks. We have KST, MACD now shifted to the upside, very bullish. Only stochastic right now is still in overbought condition. So if we're going to have a correction here towards this $11,000, also stochastic will cool off, and then we can gear up here for another big move to the upside. And if we switch over into the DXY here, you can clearly see that we lost significant support here, and currently we are getting rejected from the 50 moving average here in the daily time frame, and we will most likely see continuation towards this $92 to $91 incoming here in the next couple of days. We had here at 94.60 a sell signal, so since then we just started to plunge here, and we still have a lot of room left to the downside, and that's why I'm still leaning more that Bitcoin will go very, very bullish in the next couple of days, and that's why shorting right now might be not the best idea. And good luck for all the shorters. Of course, if you want to take a little bit of a scalp here, okay, but don't take that trade for a long-term position, because you will get wrecked for sure. If you just want to scalp a little bit, open that short right now, but make sure also to be able to close it immediately if the price is going to the opposite direction. And now let's open up the weekly time frame here in the Bitcoin price, because this chart is still looking so amazingly bullish. We had here even a close above the previous weeks here, so above the highs of the last weeks, and the next step would be of course in theory to close also now above $12,500. That will initiate really FOMO here, and we will most likely then go very, very easily towards $14,000 maybe even $16,000 in the next couple of weeks if we are able to close a weekly candle above $12,500. But already last week's here was very bullish, of course, and we're still trading above the 20 weekly moving average. And as as you can see now, the 50 is coming down here to $9,000. So I still think there is a high chance that maybe we could come down here to test these levels. But therefore, something has to happen because Bitcoin currently is looking so bullish, and to the upside, we still have no limits. We just had some little resistances from 2017 and 18 towards $20,000. But otherwise, once we're gonna break this 20K, we have no more limits above of us. And now let's have a look also into the Bollinger Band in the weekly, because here, as you can see, we closed now above $11,000. And this is what I told you, my friends, if we're gonna have a weekly close above this moving average, so if we're able to get out of this channel and break out to the upside, we will most likely come up here to test this $12,000 level, and there we're gonna see if we're gonna create here a double top formation or if we are able to go way higher than that. Because after this cool off, we now have a lot of room left to the upside, and in theory we should be now gearing up for another big parabolic move to the upside, which in theory should take out all of these $12,500 pretty easily. We have currently the stochastic shifted to the upside after being completely oversold. The problem is only here the MACD and KST, which are flattening out here. It's a bit unclear in which direction they're going right now, but if we're able to push here towards 12k and also close weekly candles at around $12,000 here, although we should have another bullish cross in the KST and MACD, and then of course we will see big continuations here to the upside. So the weekly is again looking very, very bullish in my opinion, and it's just a matter of time till we're gonna see new all-time highs. So today the conclusion is, like we had also the last couple of days, short to midterm there could be still some big pullbacks even towards $9,000, but the long term is looking so bullish that I would definitely recommend you to accumulate as much Bitcoin as you can, and the lower we go, the more you should be able to buy, because that could be really the last opportunity to buy Bitcoin so cheap. And this $9,000 to $9,600 area is really the last opportunity to buy cheap Bitcoin, unless we're getting now a double top at $12,500 and we will start a big sell-off. And also in the stock market we will have a big crash similar like we had in March, then okay, this could lead of course into lower prices, maybe even towards $7,000. But you definitely don't want to miss out the boat only because there is still a risk that we could see such a big crash. So if you accumulate Bitcoin in the next couple of days and weeks, you should be doing very fine for the next couple of years. And when you're buying Bitcoin for your HODL portfolio, you must always at least have an outlook of 4 years. If you do these small trades with longs and shorts, then of course, depending which time frame you're watching at and how you're trading, you can do these little scalps going long and short. But for the long term, it doesn't matter where you're gonna buy Bitcoin, at 10k or at 5k, in the next 1 or 2 years you will be doing very fine, and it will be just a matter at what prices you may be gonna take a little bit of profits out if you want, for example, to buy yourself some stuff or you have to pay some bills. But otherwise, just buy and hodl Bitcoin and you should be doing very fine. We most likely gonna see new all-time highs in the next couple of months, but imagine also in the next couple of years where the price will be heading to. So that's why it is very important that even if we go again parabolic, you will never go all out again. Always keep your HODL portfolio, just take a little bit of profits out if you, for example, see a better investment or you want to buy a house or a car or whatever, then okay, I can understand. But otherwise, never sell Bitcoin just to accumulate fiat, because fiat will be worth nothing in the next couple of years. So that's why I always stick here with Bitcoin. And with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up for now. If you like the content, remember to moon up the likes, very much appreciated. You can also leave me any kind of comment you want, subscribe here to the channel, and if you're interested in trading Bitcoin and other assets, make sure to use the recommended exchanges down below here in the video description. Those are the exchanges that I'm also using, and currently I'm using this unique feature from Prime XBT. I'm trying it out at the moment. I followed some of these traders here just to see how it works out. If some of you are interested in also doing like that, so if next to your own trading you want also to put here some Bitcoin and let other traders do the trading stuff for you, you can follow them here very easily. So this is a very unique feature from Prime XBT, and if you want to try it out, make sure to use the link down below here in the video description. Just top up some bitcoins there and follow, for example, here the top trader number one. This guy is already 1600% in profits. So here you can easily, for example, put one bitcoin or something like that in there, follow him, and you will copy trade him automatically. So you don't even have to watch always the charts. You just have to go here and check if this trader is doing well or not. Of course, there is also a very high risk, like you would trade at your own, but if you want to try this unique feature out, then PrimeXPT is the right place for you. And also remember that currently on Femex there is a trading event going on where you can win up to 100 Bitcoin. So if you are anyway trading on Femex, then make sure to join here with this link, the event. You will get some more bonus and also some rewards here during the event. So definitely go and try it out if you anyway are trading with leverage. So if you're trading, for example, on Bybit or Dudex, you can just transfer some Bitcoin to Femex, trade also over there during the event, get some more bonuses and less trading fees. And then at the end, when you have won, you can also send it back to the other exchanges that you're using, so very easily. And if you want, you can of course also join me over on Twitch and on Discord. We have a very nice trading chat. You find all the links down below here. So thank you very much for your support and for watching, my friends, and we're gonna see us all in the next one. Bye.